Hi everyone, I'm Natasha Alford for theGrio.com, and today we are joined by activist, writer, and daughter of the late Eric Garner. Erica Garner has gotten the entire country's attention with a new video endorsement of Senator Bernie Sanders, and now she's joining us via Skype in South Carolina. How are you doing today, Erica?
I've just been running around. My life has just been crazy, but I love it.
Tell us, what made you decide to jump into this all the way?
I reached out to his campaign like 2 months ago. So basically, like, I injected myself into this campaign. So I wrote a Washington Post op-ed, and I do YouTube videos also. So I sent over the op-ed and the YouTube video, and I told them the only way I will do it if I can have control over it. Mm-hmm. And they said, sure. So basically, the video was basically directed by me, and the script came from my op-ed.
Right. And people are saying that this is honestly one of the most powerful videos they've ever seen, even if they're not supporting Senator Sanders. Why do you think this is resonating with people? Why do you think your message is standing out?
Because it's so, like, real. Like, it hits home with a lot of people. Like, you know, I wanted them to focus on not the tragedy of my father's death, but recognize me as just, like, as an everyday person, and how this economy, you know, affects everybody.
So a lot of people have made a big deal of the fact that your grandmother actually publicly supported Hillary Clinton, and you're a millennial, you know, you're a black millennial, you support Bernie Sanders. Is there some sort of generational difference? I mean, is there a reason why you don't stand behind Hillary Clinton?
I mean, let's just keep it real. Hillary just been flip-flopping and confused her whole life. She haven't stuck to one thing. And so we need consistency, especially kids, especially young people. We need consistency. We need someone who's going to talk about our issues and not just use our issues as a political pawn just to get our vote. And what I tell people is, even if Bernie Sanders win, he still have to earn our respect. He still have to show us. When he get into office, or any elected officials, if they're going to say something, we need to hold them accountable as people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is very important. What do you say to black voters who are undecided right now? They say, you know what, Bernie doesn't do it for me, Hillary doesn't do it for me, or they don't rock with the GOP candidates. What do you say to them? This is a different election. Barack Obama is not in the mix. You know, that was very historical in its own way. What do you say to people who just, they don't feel anything right now for either candidate?
You remember in 2008 when before we had a black president, and he said, yes, we can. And he went up against every right wing that tried to throw attacks at him. This is exactly what they're doing to Bernie Sanders. Give him a chance. Do your research. He marched with Martin Luther King. He marched with Jesse Jackson. He stood up for people for housing inequality in the 1960s when he was about in his 20s. He marched with us and stood for our issues even when it wasn't popular. Martin Luther King was declared FBI's national threat. Like, just need to give him a chance and stop with the foolishness and just, you know, they can't win without us, but your voice is important. Mm-hmm. Young people, your voice is important. If you're 17 and about to turn 18 this year, you have to get yourself registered and vote, because it's either vote or die.